Hi. Ultrasound is mostly used in addition to mammography and MRI. However, it's an excellent primary tool to examine the breast in symptomatic women who have a lump or localized pain in the breast. Now, in most cases, it can be decided whether we are dealing with a benign condition or breast cancer. And in some cases, aspiration can help to differentiate complicated cysts from solid lesions, or aspiration can be used to treat abscesses. Now, ultrasound is safe, cheap and mobile, and modern handheld ultrasound machines consist of only a transducer connected to a mobile phone or tablet. These systems provide high-resolution images for just over a few thousand dollars. Now, this lecture is for anyone who is involved in breast care, but also for health workers in developing countries who may work in remote areas and have no access to mammography, but still want to help their patients. First, we're going to discuss the normal anatomy and then discuss how to differentiate benign lesions from breast cancer. Okay, here. The first layer is the skin, with underneath it a mixture of glandular tissue and fatty tissue. Now, the deepest layer is the chest wall with the pectoral muscle, the ribs, and the intercostal muscles. And then you have the lungs. Posterior to the ribs, no imaging is possible due to the absorption of the sound waves, and this results in an artifact called posterior acoustic shadowing. Here we see a normal ultrasound image of the breast. The upper gray layer is the skin. Then there is a mixture of fat, dark or hypoechoic structure, and glandular tissue, which is light gray or hyperechoic. The striped posterior layer to the breast tissue is the pectoral muscle. Here we have the rib, and posterior or deeper to the rib, there is a black area or posterior shadowing. And this is the lung. On this video, you can see the breast tissue, the pectoral muscle, the rib with posterior shadowing, and you can see the lung moving during breathing. Posterior to the lung, there is also some gray shadowing. This is called a dirty shadow. Now, most parts of the ribs are calcified, but more medially, the ribs are mainly composed of cartilage, which is hypoechoic, as we can see here. Now, by turning the position of the transducer, you can see that the rib is a longitudinal structure. In most cases, there is a mixture of fatty tissue and glandular tissue, like we see here on the ultrasound and on this illustration, and also on the mammogram, where the dark stuff is fat and the white is glandular tissue. So it's a bit like on the ultrasound. Here it is mostly glandular tissue, as seen in young women, pregnancy and breastfeeding. And here it is mostly fat. In older women, the glandular tissue is gradually replaced by fat, although some older women still may have some amount of glandular tissue. And in adipose women, there is also more fat in the breast, even in younger women. This woman felt a lump in her breast and she was worried if it could be cancer. Now, in this part of the breast, there is mainly fat, but here we have more glandular tissue, and the glandular tissue is more firm than the surrounding fat, and that makes the breast can feel bumpy or even give the impression of a mass. Like in this case, where a part of the normal glandular tissue felt like a mass. Okay. Now, we're going to discuss the four most common causes of a lump in the breast, which make up for more than 95% of all masses in the breast. Okay, very common in young women is pronounced glandular tissue, like I showed you already. It usually changes during the menstrual cycle. The breast can feel tense or sometimes painful. You also see it in pregnancy and breastfeeding. It is hyperechoic and it's always normal. Then we have cysts. Cysts are the most common masses in the breast, seen in any age group. They are fluid-filled sacs inside the breast and are always benign. It is extremely important to determine whether a palpable lump is a cyst, because then you can really reassure the patient that everything is fine. A fibroadenoma is the most common tumor in the breast, and it is always benign. It is most commonly seen in young women, especially in the age group 15 to 25 years, and seldom in women over 50. It is hypoechoic and has a regular shape with sharp borders. And finally, breast cancer, mostly seen in women over 50 years of age and not that common in younger women. It is also hypoechoic, but usually has an irregular shape. Now, our job is to determine first if a lump in the breast is normal glandular tissue. If not, is it a cyst? And if it isn't a cyst, then we have to decide if it is a benign tumor or breast cancer. And the good news is, in most cases, this is straightforward. Let's get into more detail. On ultrasound, the typical features of a cyst are an echoic pattern, also called echolucent. This means that the lesion is black. The shape is round or oval, and when it's oval, it has a horizontal orientation, parallel to the skin. We call this wider than tall. There is a sharp circumscribed margin, and there is posterior enhancement. It is brighter behind the cyst because the sound beam rushes through the cyst, which results in more echoes posterior to the cyst. Here a typical example of multiple cysts in a woman who felt a lump in her breast. Although there are many cysts, only one cyst in the center is palpable because it is round and with fluid under tension. Sometimes a woman may tell you, "Well, last week I felt nothing and now I have a 4 cm tumor. How is this possible?" Well, this cyst probably was there for many months or years, but now suddenly it's palpable due to a slight increase in fluid. Now, the other cysts are not palpable because they are not under tension and they just feel like the surrounding normal glandular tissue. Also, notice that the wall is slightly thickened when you compare it to the other cysts. Probably there is some irritation, low-grade infection, which caused the increase of fluid in the cyst. It is very common to find more cysts in a woman who presents with a palpable cyst. This woman had multiple small cysts in both breasts, but they were not palpable. Complicated cysts are cysts that have an atypical appearance. The echo pattern is hypoechoic instead of the normal anechoic or echolucent pattern. Because the content of the cyst has become more proteinaceous or viscous due to the low-grade infection or internal bleeding. And the wall may become thickened as shown earlier, and sometimes the wall can become irregular. And then it can be difficult to differentiate these cysts from cancer, especially if the content has become hypoechoic. But usually there still is posterior enhancement, which makes it very likely to be a cyst. Here a video of a palpable cyst. In this case, the cyst was painful and it was decided to do a puncture with aspiration of the fluid. Notice that the wall is a little bit thickened. As said, it is frequently a sign of low-grade infection and explains why the cyst was painful. Uncomplicated cysts are usually not painful. Now, aspiration is a quick and simpler procedure. In most cases, the fluid has a transparent yellow color, but it can be green, it can be brown, it doesn't matter. Examination of the aspirated fluid is not necessary. Next is a fibroadenoma. The typical ultrasound features are hypoechoic pattern, oval shape, sometimes round and with 2 or 3 lobulations. And the orientation is also parallel to the skin, so it's wider than tall. It has a sharp border, also called circumscribed margin. And blood flow within small vessels can sometimes be detected on color Doppler. And sometimes there's a little bit of posterior enhancement. Here, a typical fibroadenoma, oval shape, horizontal orientation, sharp border, maybe a little bit of posterior enhancement. And here another one, typical fibroadenoma. It's just anterior to the pectoral muscle, and underneath the pectoral muscle is a breast implant, which we will discuss later. Now, if this was a palpable mass in a patient over 50 years old, then you wouldn't be so sure, and probably you would do a biopsy or at least a follow-up to rule out cancer. But usually this is not a problem. Here a typical fibroadenoma in a 19-year-old, and in the same patient another one, and another one, and even a fourth. So this is a common finding. When you see one fibroadenoma, you can frequently find more in both breasts, and it's something that is extremely uncommon in breast cancer. This mass was biopsied because of the age of the patient, although it looked like a fibroadenoma. Well, it turned out to be a fibroadenoma in an older patient. This mass was biopsied because it had an irregular shape and looked like a carcinoma, but this also turned out to be a fibroadenoma. Fibroadenomas sometimes have calcifications, but then they are larger than the small calcifications that we encounter in carcinomas. Here, a typical fibroadenoma with a gross calcification. These calcifications are different from the small calcifications that we see in breast cancer, like for instance here. These are very tiny calcifications called microcalcifications in breast cancer, and sometimes they are not visible on ultrasound but only on a mammogram. Let's continue with breast cancer. Breast cancer is the most common malignant tumor in women. A woman's risk of getting breast cancer increases with age. Most women diagnosed with breast cancer are over the age of 50, but younger women can also get breast cancer. The key features on ultrasound are hypoechoic mass, mostly irregular shape, but sometimes round or oval. But when it's oval in shape, the orientation is not parallel to the skin, but usually more vertically oriented. The border is not sharp, but uncircumscribed. It may be indistinct, angular, microlobulated or spiculated, and sometimes with a hyperechoic halo. And a carcinoma may have a posterior shadowing and small calcifications. Here an example of a typical breast cancer. Diagnosis made in a split second. It is hyperechoic, irregular, with an indistinct border, and notice the hyperechoic halo. Here we have normal tissue, and then it stops. This is all cancer. Here another example. On this image, everything is normal. We have the skin, mostly glandular tissue, pectoral muscle, ribs and lung. But here is a small breast cancer. Now, in this video I showed you that when a woman presents with a lump in her breast, by far these are the most common findings. It can be pronounced glandular tissue, no problem. It can be a cyst, spot diagnosis. Sometimes a complicated cyst can be difficult, but you can do aspiration. Then we have fibroadenomas, very common in young women. Can be a problem when you see one fibroadenoma in an older woman. And then we have breast cancer. Okay, now in the next video I will show you more examples of breast cancer, and I will show you what to do when benign tumors look like cancer or cancer looks like a benign tumor. And I will show you abscesses and some uncommon benign tumors. Okay, hope to see you in the next video. Bye bye.